He's a fitness trainer, boxer, and son of the legendary fighter and grill maker, George Foreman. And like his father, George Foreman III has fought his way to victory inside and outside the ring. In his new book, The Fighting Spirit, George shares 12 laws he's learned to help you beat anything life throws your way.
Well, joining us now is George Foreman III. And George, thanks for being with us. Can you show people your hands, just how big they are?
Not as big as my dad's.
I shook your father's hand, and I was like, please don't ever hit me with that.
I said he has a paw.
He does. He does. And he had a great career, and he didn't want you to be a boxer.
No, not
at all.
You know, I think because he knew how hard it was, and because when he came back the second time, when he wanted to do a lot of other things, but he wasn't qualified. The only thing he was qualified to do was be a boxer and to put food on the table, at least. And so he said, I want you to have a college degree so you never have that moment where you say, you know what, at all times, I know I can do something else. So until I graduated from college, couldn't talk about boxing, couldn't talk about girls.
And you went into boxing. You had a great career. 15-0 is an awesome record. And I think you could have gone further with that, but you said no. Why?
You know what? I got into it because I wanted to know what it was like to fight, to understand that side of my father, and to have that fight or flight moment in the ring in real life and see what it was like, and to lose some weight. That's all it was about. It wasn't about being a professional boxer. And me and my father, who was my trainer, we just got out of hand. And at some point, I said, whoa, this is not what I wanted to do. I want to train people. And I discovered that during my years as a boxer because my dad insisted, if I train you, you're going to train others. And I found out I like being a personal trainer, training kids to box.
Why? What is it about you that likes that?
Because, you know, when you're working on yourself, that's it. When you have a team of 20, 30 people, you can not only teach them all, boxing and see them progress, but you can change their life a little bit. You can keep them from dropping out of school. You can, some of them will come to lose weight just so that their wife wouldn't divorce them. And then you see the wife coming in and working out with them. You can change people's lives. If you do it for yourself, it's just you. But you can have 20 or 30 people that you can change with fitness.
It's unusual to hear you say, I want to live for others. I want to help others. That's what drives me.
And it's not anything I chose. What I figured out, though, was when I was training myself, I was like, I can't wait to get out of here. I can't wait to go home. But when I was training other people, they shut off the lights. I turn them back on and say, I'll close. You couldn't pull me out of the gym. I love it. That was just something I found out, though.
All right. You've got a book out, The Fighting Spirit, The Art of Winning Your Fight. Is that the motivation behind this book? You want to share the secrets that you found in trying to help others?
Yeah, you know, I'd hanging out with my father, he had taught me so many different things that I learned that should be true for everybody. But then I met this lady named Mary McAlary, who's diagnosed with MS at the age of 57. 7 years later, almost 10 years later, is symptom-free because she, just like everybody else, was taking medication, stuck on her couch, but she learned how to eat, and that changed her life, and she's got more energy than ever. Now, I was hearing Mary counsel somebody, and she speaks just like my dad, and I found out these fight laws I had written a while back can apply to anybody because Mary, when we discussed them, she was like, that's how I live my life. And so I said, finally, I have a story that I can combine these with to share with people because I don't really have a story, but Mary does. And so the goal is...
You've got a story.
Well, not like Mary's.
They're different, but you've got your own story.
But it's the story of others that I think can go a little further to show that these fight laws apply to everything. That's all I wanted to show.
All right, let's talk about one of them, the law of intention. What's that?
The law of intention, really, it's do you believe? It's more about faith, in my opinion. I actually changed it in my last copy. It's about the faith to decide you want to do something, pray for it, and then have the faith to put the work that goes along with what you prayed for. Because when you're working and being, you know, hard work and dedication, when you're doing this, there's no immediate return. And so having that type of faith throughout your hard work, knowing that it's coming, you prayed for it. It may take 5 years, it may take 6 years, just like Mary, it's coming.
Act like you believe.
Act like you believe. Don't just
just say it.
Yeah.
Act like you believe.
Don't just pray.
Live
it.
Like you believe, and it'll transform you. Why do people give up?
I think people give up sometimes because they haven't heard stories of other people who faced their same challenge, who've had those same moments and persevered and won their fight. I think they haven't heard those stories. If they have, I think they wouldn't give up. I think that's part of it. And sometimes they don't have enough support. And sometimes they don't have faith.
What's your dream?
My dream is ultimately to have, to build this community, whether it's virtual, whether it's out of my gym, whatever it is, where people continue to share their stories online, social media, whatever it is, and inspire others by sharing their stories. And it becomes kind of this huge community that when people need inspiration, they just check into their community and find someone else who's experienced it and say, you know what? I'm gonna try what they tried and see if it helps me win my fight. I'm not gonna give up because they're not giving up, to create this team of everyday fighters.
If people wanna join your community, how do they find you?
What we're doing is you just go to everybodyfights.com and there's a button called community, and go down and click share your story. And it's really simple, and I'll email you back.
All right, personally?
Yeah, I will. I email right. everybody personally. Got right. some cool stories.
You can get a personal email from George Foreman III. And you can learn more about George's fight laws in his book, The Fighting Spirit, The Art of Winning Your Fight. It's available nationwide wherever books are sold. And George, you are an inspiration to me. Yeah, and you're going to have a great story. You are going to have a great
story. Maybe when I come back, I'll have a story.
And it's going to continue to evolve. God's going to take you through a lot of different stages, and it's going to be great.